This ComTV Community Report brought to you by Glen Yuhas, Panorama Family Fun Center, Taco Time, Hemp Town Rock, Icy Mountain Water Corporation, and Animal World. The Red Cliff Museum opened its doors to an avid audience, kicking off the 100th birthday of the town. Artifacts from throughout Red Cliff's past were there to remind residents of their history. Vi Rigger looks after the town's local museum. She says the response has been great, and it gives the town's older population a chance to get together with some old friends.
Why is it important to us? We're proud of our town. We're proud of our history. And we want people to be educated in our history as far as what Red Cliff is all about.
Among the different activities planned for the weekend, there was a pancake breakfast, a parade, a movie in the park, and a Red Cliff bus tour, which included a trip to the local cemetery to help residents explore some of this town's vast culture. Dr. Michael Stoner of Montana is the grandson of Robert Royer Stoner, the man credited for founding Red Cliff. He first visited Red Cliff in 1997 at the request of his sister and would later come back with his family to help celebrate the 100th anniversary.
My thought was, what did it look like 100 years ago? And, you know, the interest of trying to picture what my grandparents did and what they saw. And that was one of the interesting things about coming here at first, was to get a feeling for where they had worked and developed and grew their family, which was my father.
Cliff Dacre, a Red Cliff resident and historian, volunteered to be a tour guide for the Centennial Bus Tour, explaining the town's local landmarks. He says that in 1999, a lot of the industries that founded the town were no more, so the museum came up with the idea to use memorable stones to mark some of these foundations.
Red Cliff was not developed as an agricultural center. First of all, because it wasn't developed when the CPR came through, where most of the communities along the CPR line were all agricultural based. Red Cliff started in about 1906 and it was industry, and it's always been industry. And particularly with the brick industry, because there was three brick plants here, and I don't think any other community in Canada or anywhere else possibly can, you know, brag about having three brick factories in a town that only had a population of about 2,000 people.
Now, as much as many of the industries that once built up this town have vanished, the people and the history still remain, giving rise to hope for Red Cliff's next 100 years. For your ComTV Community Report, I'm Travis Burke. ComTV Community Television is a local web-based broadcaster supporting the Medicine Hat and surrounding regions, paid for in support by local businesses throughout southeastern Alberta. If you have any events or news you think is important, we want to know about it. Send us an email. Let us know how we can better serve you. Thank you for supporting your local businesses and helping us keep local community television on the web.